Hi, I'm Jenny Jewell, a retired emergency dispatcher. Welcome to Call Autopsy, and this one, we're going to be autopsying a drunk driver calling themselves in. So this is kind of a fun one, but let's go ahead and get this going here.
Clark County 911.
Somebody's really drunk driving down Granton Road.
Which way are they going?
They are going,
towards Granton or towards Nielsville?
Towards Granton.
Okay, are you behind them, or?
No, I am them.
You am them?
Yes, I am them.
Okay, so you want to call and report that you're driving drunk?
Yes.
Okay, what's your name?
Mary.
Okay, hold on 1 second, Mary, okay?
Okay.
Are you still driving right now?
Yes.
Do you want to stop driving before you get in an accident?
Yes, I will stop.
Okay, you going to stop right now?
Yep, I will stop right now.
Okay, just hold on a second, okay?
Okay, I'm stopping.
Okay, just hang on the phone, okay?
Okay.
Still there, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Mary, sorry about that. What's your last name, Mary?
Stroy.
Are you stopped right now?
Yes, I am. Should I turn my car off and turn the flashers on?
Yep, that's fine. If you want to turn it off and turn the flashers on, so then we can find you. Where are you coming from, Mary?
I came from Nielsville. I'm coming from...
And you were drinking in Nielsville?
I was drinking all over. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be driving. How many people do you get that call in on themselves?
Not many. But I guess it's better than getting in an accident and killing yourself or somebody else.
No, I don't want to hurt anybody. I'm drunk. Am I going to go to jail?
What's that?
Will I go to jail?
I guess if you're over the legal limit, I mean...
Well, I know I am. This really sucks. I'm sitting here calling in on myself. I see somebody coming, but I...
Frank Mary 3006.
You see somebody coming, you said?
Yeah, but I think they're going right by. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no, there goes the flashers. They're here.
Okay, I will let you go speak with them.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Okay, now we all have to admit that that call receiver did a bang-up job. Let's hear it for them, all right? And if you're that, because again, I know the Sub Rosa, and I was a number for a very long time. I liked being the anonymous voice. And if you like to stay anonymous, don't tell me who you are. But if you did take this call and you want to share your experience, absolutely feel free. But let's go ahead and autopsy this call. And I really enjoyed it. So let's go ahead and do this. And we are going to be looking for, again, the three bullet point, well, the where, what, who, and additional details. And again, where, so they know where they're going. What, because we need to know what's going on. Who, because if they flee the scene, we know who it is. And that's part of it. There's a lot more to it than that. And then additional details to keep your officers or aid services safe. So let's go ahead and...
Clark County 911.
Somebody's really drunk driving down Granton Road.
Okay, so we saw Clark County 911 announced as Clark County 911, so that's their opening. They went directly into their where, what, and who.
Which way are they going?
They are going...
So right now we have what, which is a drunk driver. Now we're getting where. And again, the order of things changes. It's so fluid. You just got to, you know, get the information as you can.
Towards Granton or towards Nielsville?
Towards Granton.
Okay, are you behind them, or?
No, I am them.
Okay, so there's a twofold reason for asking that question. If you're behind the drunk driver, they normally recommend that you not be behind the drunk driver, or, you know, you just kind of back off. They don't want you in danger. So it's like it's a matter of officer safety, your safety, and just seeing, you know, can you get any other information before they have you back off, right?
You am them?
Yes, I am them.
Yep, so they called themselves in.
Okay, so you want to call and report that you're driving drunk?
Yes.
See, this person, I appreciate this person. I don't like that they drove drunk, But I like that they're no longer driving drunk or don't want to.
Okay, what's your name?
Mary.
Okay, hold on 1 second, Mary, okay?
Okay, and keep in mind, again, there's a lot of stuff going on with what he's doing in the background with building the call, getting the dispatch out, seeing who's close. This sounds like a very small center, or at least a center that they're very tight with their team, because you can hear them building the call, and then how fast the officer answers up is just beautiful. But these are two. There's actually, yeah, you'll see.
Okay.
Are you still driving right now?
Yes.
Do you want to stop driving before you get in an accident?
Yes, I will stop.
Okay, you gonna stop right now?
Yep, I will stop right now.
Okay.
All right, so there we go with our additional details on safety area of things. Yes, they want them to no longer be moving. Not moving when you're drunk is a pretty good idea.
Just hold on a second, okay?
Okay, I'm stopping.
Okay, just hang on the phone, okay?
Yep, this okay. is where he's either...
Still there, sir?
Yes, no,
ma'am.
Mary, sorry about that. Yeah. What's your last name, Mary?
Sorry.
Are you stopped right now?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so what happened here is he was putting out the dispatch and seeing who's closest, you could tell. And then, you know, coming back, after doing that, they lost track of the gender of the caller, which can happen. Please never take that personal. They're juggling chainsaws in the background to help you out, so.
Should I turn my car off and turn the flashers on?
Yep, that's fine if you want to turn it off and turn the flashers on. So then
yes, please. Makes you easier to find, too.
Find you.
Yeah.
Where are you coming from, Mary?
I came from Neillsville. I'm coming from...
And you were drinking in Neillsville?
Okay, and so another reason for that is if a bar... There's a lot of stuff going on in this call. If a bar overserves an individual... That's a problem. So they kind of want to find out where are you drinking, see if there's a bigger problem at hand here. You know, were you overserved and then drove? Because that's a whole other legal issue.
I was drinking all over. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be driving.
Bingo.
How many people do you get that call in on themselves?
Not many.
And from personal experience, I have never had anyone call in saying that they were drunk driving. Never. Not once. Nope.
But I guess it's better than getting in an accident and killing yourself or somebody else.
No, I don't want to hurt anybody. I'm drunk. Am I going to go to jail?
What's that?
Will I go to jail?
Okay. So remember, well, maybe you don't. So if this is a new video to you, I have another video where we address that people... there are dispatchers giving proper expectations, like in the waffle call. And then we also have officers that, again, in the training tape, can't say a word because you can't give legal advice. What this gentleman is doing is giving proper expectations about what may happen. So this is still valid.
I guess if you're over the legal limit, I mean...
Well, I know I am. This really sucks. I'm sitting here calling on myself. I see somebody coming,
but you're alive, Mary, and I think that was the big part. That's the important part. Everybody's alive.
Somebody coming, you said?
Yeah, but I think they're going right by. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no, they're both flashers. They're here.
Okay, I will let you go speak with them.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Very great call. So kudos to the call receiver. Or call receiver dispatcher, depending on what was going on. It sounded like call receiver dispatcher. Sounds like they were in the hot seat for dispatching also. So, but I could be wrong. They could have just been building out the call and then talking to their dispatcher. Because again, living, breathing entity in those centers, at least to more my personal experience anyway. I'm sure every culture is different. So just like all of the dispatch centers are different. But yeah, great call. Kudos, man. That was one, you know, they kept it together. Two, they got all their information. And then, you know, life and safety. Everything worked out really well. But again, if you have any other information about this call or you know, you don't have to share anything. Because again, sub rosa, wink, It's going to be a lot of things I don't talk about. But yeah, hopefully you enjoyed it. Please take care. Be good. Bye-bye.